Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to this channel, then let me introduce myself. My name is Pia Pai. I'm an international flight attendant based in Doha, Qatar. And I do travel vlogs, cabin crew tips, and stuff like that. So if you want to get updated with me, then hit that red button down below. So today we'll be talking about the Qatar Airways cabin crew requirements and how you can apply for it. However, I may have to divide it into two parts just in case this video gets too long. Alright, so I think there's a bit of a misconception here that for you to become a flight attendant, you need to be at least single with no kids. You should have a perfect vision, perfect set of teeth, or you should have no scars at all. Well, this may be applicable to some other airlines, but with the airline that I'm working for, that's not part of the requirements. So if you meet the criteria that I'll be sharing with you today, then you should consider applying. Right, so let's begin now. First requirement they require is you need to be at least 21 years old. Now they have a reason for that. So if you haven't reached your 21st birthday, relax, take it easy, just take your time will come. What I can suggest to you right now is prepare yourself, ask those people for best practices and tips so that when your time will come, you are ready. Now, if you ask me what's the maximum limit, that I cannot answer. However, I flew with a lot of crew who started their first flying career at the age of 34 or 35. So if I were you, I will try my luck. And I think it's not yet too late to pursue your dream, right? Okay, so the second one would be you need to reach at least 212 centimeters. Now that would be on tiptoes. Now before you say, oh, I'm just 5'2 or 5'1 or even 5'0. Before saying that, why don't you measure yourself first? If you can reach 212 centimeters, that will be on tiptoes and see how it goes. If you can reach, that means you're lucky. I've seen a lot of crew who are quite short. However, they have longer arm reach. That's why they're able to get through. So before you say never, try measuring yourself now and let's see if you get any chance at all, okay? The third one would be you need to have at least a minimum high school education with fluency in written and spoken English. You don't need to have a bachelor's degree to become a cabin crew. You just need to be at least high school graduate with fluency in English and you're good to go. That's it. The fourth one would be you need to have an excellent health and fitness. Now this is not just with Qatar Airways, this is applicable to all other airlines. Why? Because fatigue is one of the major factors that you will be dealing with once you start flying. So it is very important for you to really be fit and healthy. And another reason why they need you to be healthy, it's because the kind of workload that you will have once you start flying, you will have a lot of back pains. You will complain a lot of them. I've seen a lot of crew resigning because of this kind of condition. So it is very important for you to be in good shape. All right. The fifth one would be you need to be willing to be relocated to Doha, Qatar. Now, once you start flying, Doha will be your home base. Now, this may sound simple and easy. However, I've seen a lot of crew going back home while even they're still on training. They all want to go back home because they cannot manage to be away from their loved ones. Plus, Doha is a quite conservative country. So if you're not willing to adjust to their culture, then you're not going to like it there. And you will just end up going back to your home base or to your country. And the last one would be you need to have an outgoing personality with good interpersonal skills and the ability to work with a multinational team. In this company, there are 115 nationalities that you will be dealing with. So it is very essential for you to adjust and respect other cultures. And you need to be a team player. And how do we know that you are a team player? And that is through the group discussion that you will be experiencing once you go through the stages in the open day assessment. So if you want to know the process of the open day, then you can click on that link above on the upper right corner. Now you have come to the most exciting part, and that is how to apply for a Qatar Airways cabin crew. Alright, so let's all begin. There are two ways to apply to become a flight attendant with Qatar Airways, and that is through an online application, and the second one would be going to recruitment dates. So what you're going to do is you just have to type in qatarairways.com, and it will lead you to this page. And then what you're going to do is go scroll down below, and you will see careers. So you click on careers here, and it should lead you to another page, which is the current opportunity page. And then what you're going to do is type in cabin crew, and then click go. Alright, so here you see all cabin crew recruitment. They have events, they have a recruitment event in Prague, they have in Kuala Lumpur. All of these are for cabin crew recruitment. So you just have to click, let's say you are from Kuala Lumpur, you just have to click on this link, and then you'll see all the information that you need. So here you see in the event the date that they require you to come, the venue, and then here, and then the attire. And you will see here as well that they require you to bring along with you the CV, the passport photocopy, passport photograph taken in the same dress code, which is formal business attire, and a photocopy of your highest education certificate. Now let's say you don't have any passport yet because you haven't been traveling outside the country, so that's okay, you don't have to worry about that. What is the most important thing that you need to bring with you is your CV and a recent full-length colored photo and a passport size photo. That's it. You don't really have to bring all these other things here because they will just ask you to provide them once your application is successful with them. All right, so these are the things that you need to just follow if you get tired. And then that is only if you apply personally. Now let's say you don't have any access and Qatar Airways is not really going to your country, so what you're gonna do is you apply online and just have to click here, apply for vacancy, and it will lead you to this page. So you just have to register your information here, and then start submitting all the documents that they need you to submit. So it's as easy as that. So we'll just have to cross this out. So these are the descriptions, and then here they even put the requirement. So they don't really put like, say you need to have a vision of 2020, or you need to have you need to have prefix at a T, or you need to have a normal BMI and all. So it doesn't really show in there. So there's no problem for you. If you meet all these criteria, then you are always free to apply. All right, so I think that will be it. It was very simple. Anytime you're ready, you can always apply. I hope you like this video, and just hit the like and subscribe buttons for you to get more updates from me. I'll see you again next time, guys. Bye for now.